in the field of posture therapy and ergonomics, there's a big debate on whether you should use armrests when you sit on your chair or not. I'd like to give you my nuanced point of view on this topic. I'm Olivier Girard, I'm an ergonomist, a posture therapist, the author of the Posture Manual and the creator of the 10 Weeks Online Back Saving Program. So why this debate around the armrests? Basically, it's a debate on who should carry your arms. You have three different candidates. Candidate number one is the upper trapezius, you know. If I go like this, my upper trapezius is carrying my arms from above. The problem with the upper trapezius is that it's not a muscle that's meant to bear sustained contraction, and it becomes painful, causing neck pain and headaches. An alternative candidate is a third party. Third party could be supporting from below, like your armrests, or right now, the pockets of my jeans are actually third parties. They are bearing the weight of my arms, hence relieving the upper trapezius. The third candidate is the latissimus dorsi, and this is what I would like to detail in this video. The latissimus dorsi is a fantastic muscle. It's fan-shaped, exactly like your gluteals, actually, and it goes on half the pelvic crest, all your lumbar vertebrae, your mid-back vertebrae, half of them, and all these fibers that start in this large area converge here under the humerus, i.e. when the fibers of the latissimus dorsi are mobilized, I didn't say contracted, I said mobilized, they can build a pillar, a column for the weight of your arms and support it not from above, but from below. And the latissimus dorsi is a muscle that can bear sustained contraction. So actually the idea is if you use your latissimus dorsi, you don't need neither the upper trapezius nor a third party. Why am I not so enthusiastic about using a third party? Well, because it limits the mobility of my arms. Obviously, you see here, when my hands are in my pocket, I can't do anything with my hands. So of course, my upper trapezius is relieved, but so what? What can I do? And the same in your office. When you sit at work, if you have your armrests here, well, again, your upper trapezius is relieved because your armrests are bearing from below the weight of your arms. But look, the mobility of my elbow is now limited because there's friction of the armrest against my forearm. Why is this mobility of the elbow so necessary? Well, because the elbow and the wrist are complementary joints. Look, the elbow moves your hand in the horizontal plane, whilst the wrist moves your hand in the vertical plane. So if you have anything that prevents your elbow from moving smoothly, the wrist will move not only like this, but also like that, which is called ulnar or radial deviation. And this ulnar and radial deviation is a source of epicondylitis or tendinitis here in the wrist area or in the elbow area. So basically, if you don't want that, your elbow should be free to move. And if it's free to move, well, it's difficult for it to rest on something by definition. And my analysis would be exactly the same about leaning on your desk. It's the same problem. So you'll tell me very rightly, yeah, but why do people have armrests then? Well, the history of armrests is the following. Is chair manufacturers observe that people don't use the lumbar support of their chair and therefore they tend to slouch. So originally they thought, okay, we're going to make the chairs reclining a bit, yeah, and therefore people will have an easier time gliding towards their lumbar support. But the price to pay for that is that their arms will be behind their hip joints, i.e. reaching their keyboard will be a huge effort. How am I going to resolve that? Well, I'm going to put armrests and therefore people will be relaxed to work. Yeah, maybe you're kind of relaxed because, I mean, we still didn't talk about your head. You see that my head is actually pushed forward. I would need to be like this for my head to be relaxed. So maybe now I'm relaxed, but I can't move. Yeah? How am I going to get my mouse? How am I going to get anything? So this is why I claim that using your latissimus dorsi is a better alternative. But indeed, it's true that to use your latissimus dorsi, you need to learn how to use it. The key is to understand that the latissimus dorsi is also an extensor of your trunk, you know? It helps preventing slumping in your torso. Therefore, if you're here or if you're there, your latissimus dorsi is gone and you cannot use it to support your arms from below. For your latissimus dorsi to be here, you need to sit on your sitting bones and slightly forward. You see, I'm like probably 3-4 degrees forward. There I feel a tonus here on the sides of my torso, and this is the latissimus dorsi. So now someone's here under the arms to relieve the upper trapezius and carry my arms. Of course, I'm not sitting well yet. To be sitting well, I need to give my weight to the lumbar support. So in this position, my latissimus dorsi is here and helps me carrying my arms whilst preserving their mobility. As soon as I'm there, I've lost my latissimus dorsi. So to cut a long story short, what's my take on armrests? You see, I have a chair with armrests, but I don't use them when I need mobility, when I need to work, and I will use them as an excuse to be lazy whenever I have something much more static, like, you know, say for example a call, or that I take as a hand free, you know, then, you know, the armrest is used to hold the arm, which stays static because it holds the phone. It can also be that, you know, I want to watch, I don't know, a YouTube video, for example, and then I can be like this, of course, no problem. But armrests will be used in my practice only for static tasks, and they will be used provided that they are soft and padded so that they limit the risk of compression here. So basically, what this means is that Mother Nature designed your body with an internal armrest, which is called latissimus dorsi. The only thing is that you need some training to learn how to use your latissimus dorsi. Your latissimus dorsi will work only if your sitting posture is all right. If you need detailed help on how to use the latissimus dorsi when you sit or when you lift loads, well, you should consider joining the 10 weeks online back saving program. This is the type of topics that we touch at. But you see, the using the latissimus dorsi is conditioned by many other things, such as where do you put your pelvis, your spine, etc. And this is why it cannot be resolved just like that.